Now, one of the basic elements of mixing is adjusting levels of individual parts in a project so they sound well together. We're going to take a look at how to make use of the mixer to adjust the levels of individual parts of your arrangement. We're also going to adjust the stereo image of your track by panning certain elements left or right or off-center so you get this nice wide stereo image. Let's now take a look at how we can adjust the level and panning of individual tracks to set up the mix of a project. Now, I have a fairly extensive arrangement over here. Let's have a quick listen to this. Now, the best way to approach this is to work in smaller chunks. So I'm just going to hold down command and select a small section over here, and we'll just focus on the levels in this section. Now we can choose to do our level and panning adjustments in the channel rack, because as you can see here, every channel here has level controls with these set of knobs and panning controls with these set of knobs. And that's very convenient. So we don't even have to go to the mixer. We can just adjust level and panning directly in the channel rack. But then, assuming that all these individual parts are routed to the mixer, you can also adjust the level and panning over here. Now, I would recommend to adjust the level and panning in the mixer, because otherwise it can get a little confusing. So imagine in the channel rack, if you had set one of the sounds to be panned a bit to the left, and now that sound is going in to the mixer, and in the mixer, the panner is set in the center, but you are hearing the sound a bit to the left, and this can get a little confusing. So I'm going to reset this back to the center, close out the channel rack, and do all the level and panning in the mixer. Now in the mixer, all these channels eventually are routed to the master track over here. So right now, let's focus in on the drum section over here. So we have a kick, hats, snare, clap, and glitch groove tracks. You can hold down command and click on the mute button to solo the track. And then just regular click on the other tracks to add on to solo them as well. I want the kick to be a bit more significant in the mix, so I'm going to make it a bit louder. The hats I'm going to pan a bit to the left. And also I'm going to make it a bit quieter. The snare quieter as well. I'm going to pan the clap a bit to the right. And I'll also make it a bit quieter. This glitch groove, I just want this to be a background element, so I'll make it much quieter. Somewhere down there. Alright, so now I'm happy with the overall balance of the drums. Let's hold on command, click here twice to unsolo everything, and we can listen to how the drums sound in context of the rest of the arrangement. Alright, so let's isolate parts here again. I want to hear all these together. I'm going to now introduce the bass. Make it a bit louder. Now let's say for some reason I would like to control the level of the bass and all the drums together with one slider. We can do that by routing individual tracks to any available empty insert in the mixer. So let's see how we can do that. I'm going to hold down command, click and drag over here to select all these tracks. So these are all the drums, they've been selected. Now I want to add the bass to that selection. So I'll hold down Command and Shift, and now the bass has been added to that selection. All right, so now on Insert 18, I'm going to right click here, and I'm going to choose Route to this track only. So what that does is it ensures that all these selected tracks are disconnected from the master or wherever they were connected to, and they are routed to this track over here. So now if I solo this track, and I'll go ahead and rename this, I'll call it drums and bass. So that's all the drums and the bass routed to one track. And if for any reason I want to make the combination a bit quieter or louder, I can do that over here. Again, let's hear everything together. So like that, once you're happy with one section of the track, you can move on to another section of the track, bring in all the other instruments that are being heard, adjust the individual levels, pan them around, and eventually you will have a good level and stereo balance in your mix. We'll be right back.